special presentation of Benny Hinn Ministries, featuring crusade highlights from Atlanta, Georgia.
On Christ, the solid rock, I stand. All of the grounds and seekings. Listen, if your hope is in anything or anyone else, you're going to fail. If your hope is in Jesus, you're going to win. You cannot fail if you're trusting the Lord. He will not let you go. Don't you remember what he said? He said, if you build your life on the rock, and the rock is his word, everything he said is solid ground. If your life is built upon the Lord, no devil in hell can knock you down. Nobody. No storm, nothing. Nothing. Say nothing. Now lift your hands and thank him that there's nothing in heaven, nothing on earth, nothing under the earth that can shake you, nothing. As long as you trust him. Come on. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. Lift that hand, sing it all. Why I ask you to lift your hands to heaven, I don't just do it so you can lift your hands and then get tired, you know. Why do we lift our hands? Well, look at your children, for example, when you walk in the room and they want to get a hug from you. What do? They reach out. What happens when you see somebody you haven't seen a long time? I mean, you don't even think about it. You just, well, he's God Almighty. He is God Almighty. Isn't that just some friend of yours? When you lift your hand, you're saying, Lord, I want to give you a big hug because I miss you and I love you. On Christ the solid, I stand on all other ground, it's sinking sand. In the presence of Jesus the Nazarene, and wonder why he would love me. I'm a sinner, condemned, unclean, but thank God he didn't. Thank God he shed his blood. Somebody say amen. Amen. Sing with me a glorious old hymn. Come on. I stand amazed in the presence of Jesus the Nazarene, and wonder he could love me, a sinner, condemned, unclean. And high. you ring it, and how marvelous, how wonderful, and my song shall ever be. How marvelous, how wonderful is my Savior's love for me. Saints, what a day it's going to be when we stand and see His lovely face. What a wonderful day that will be. Come on, lift that hand, sing it again, the chorus, and how marvelous, how wonderful, and my song shall ever be. How marvelous, oh Lord, how wonderful is my Savior's love for me.
And with the band something glory on His face I that shall see, will be my joy through the ages to sing of His love for me.
Sing it, saints, how marvelous, how wonderful, that my song shall ever be. How marvelous,
how wonderful is
my Savior's love. Come on, give the Lord a mighty, mighty shout. God bless you. You may be seated. Thank you, choir. You may be seated. Oh, I tell you what, if the rapture happens while we're in this crusade, I'm ready. How about you? What a mighty God. Faithful He is. Faithful. And to see this fabulous crowd here on Thursday night, Atlanta, Georgia, Jesus sure loves Atlanta. And Atlanta sure loves Jesus. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I don't care what your problem is. Honestly, I don't care. I don't care if the doctor said you have one day to live. Do you know why? Because there is enough of God's presence here to heal you. I don't care if you're in such trouble that you're just under that whole pile of a mess and don't know how to get out. You know why I don't care? Because Jesus is here and He can fix anything. Anything. We live in a very negative world. It's never half full, it's half empty. Everything about this world is negative. It's always partly cloudy, never mostly sunny. They think negatively. You know why? In many ways you can't blame them, because all of us were there one time. Ever since Adam sinned, the whole human race has been going backwards, in reverse. The first man that God created, named Adam, went from life to death, and from liberty to bondage, and from light to darkness. He went backwards, he didn't go forwards. So the whole human race has been going backwards ever since, looking through the rear view mirror, going back. But if you know Jesus, He'll put your life back in drive and take you forwards. Just Jesus. What's His name?
Jesus.
What's His blessed name?
Jesus.
That's right. So, don't worry about it. It's going to be all right. Look, everybody here, my wife, myself, we've all faced moments where we said, Lord, are you there? Where are you, Lord? Anybody ever faced that? But amazingly, he always shows up. May I add, never too early. Always on time. Always just on time he shows up. When you think you're gonna die, when you think, Lord, if you don't show up quick, it's over. Just like Peter, just before the man was dead, he was sinking, if you remember, in the Sea of Galilee, and just wham at the last minute. But Jesus said, now why did you question? Why did you fear? Trust the Lord tonight, please. You may be sitting there with pain all over your body. You may be sitting there with problems only God and you know about. But this Bible says, all things are possible to him that believes. All things. Everything. Great is thy faithfulness. Please tell him.
Great is thy faithfulness.
Look up and tell him.
Morning by morning, new mercies I see.
All I have needed. Come on, tell him, saints.
Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness.
Isn't that the truth? So true, isn't it? So glad to see Rex Humbard here on the platform, that precious man of God. And I am so very glad his wife Maud Amy is right here. Please stand up, Maud Amy, please, darling. Give her a big God bless you. And Elizabeth, we haven't seen you in ages on television, but I'm glad you came with your mom. So would you please stand up and let the people see you? Elizabeth Humboldt, give her a big God bless you. Rex, I tell you what, I love you with all my heart. You and Maud Amy are so precious to me. You know, the Lord has given me some very close and dear friends. Otto Roberts and Evelyn, Rex and Maud Amy, Paul and Jen Crouch, and very few others. These are precious. You talk about saints of God. They're right here. Right here. Rex, come on and say hello to the people, please. Come on, let's honor this man of God. Let's all stand and honor this man of God. Come on, saints. Let him know you love him, would you? I used to watch the Cathedral of Tomorrow when I was a young Christian. When my mom and dad weren't saved and family did not know the Lord, I'd sit there on Sunday morning and I'd watch Rex and I'd watch Catherine Kuhlman. And boy, you talk about getting blessed. How many years ago would watch these great programs on Sunday morning? Let me just wave at me if you look at that, Rex. And we'd listen to you sing with your family and bless us with these powerful, right to the point sermons. I still remember the sermon you preached where Jesus said, let's go to the other side. Remember that?
Yes.
You remember that? And that was such a powerful sermon. One of the most powerful stories is the stories of little Johnny. Yes.
you got more people saved with that little story than any other story I think you've ever told. Only Rex can do it like that. Come on, saints, one more time, tell him you love him.
Well, I could say I love Benny. I love him more the longer I know him, and I've known him for many years. Benny and his dear wife have become very personal friends to Maud Amy and I. Years ago, like 53 years ago, Billy Graham and I were in Youth for Christ together. Then Oral Roberts, over 50 years ago. So we've had wonderful friends there. But along comes Benny Hinn, and he's become the closest to my heart that I've ever had in the 69 years in God's Word. And I believe that God has always had a man in the time of need. Children of Israel in Egypt, Moses became that man. Abraham became that man of faith. And on down through the New Testament, like right after the outpouring of the Spirit, the church wanted to see people saved. And the man that was lame was healed. And suddenly Peter got up and preached. He was the man that day. And over 5,000 people came to the Lord Jesus Christ. And I thank God for it. Down through these many, many years, I've met many, many ministers, many people in God's Word. I've loved them all. I've prayed for them all. But I've never prayed as much as I've been praying for Benny Hinn and the ministry that God has called him to. You see, I preached for years that the great day would come when this gospel shall be preached in all nations. I started out with a radio and it expanded, and then the TV and it expanded. And now, the opportunity to go into all the world has been thrust upon the shoulders of special servants that God has called and laid his hand upon. And as sure as I stand on this platform tonight, Benny Hinn is anointed, called a man of God for this hour. I believe it with all of my heart. Not only in America, but all around the world, they're hearing the gospel. I hear of the great crusades overseas. Thousands and thousands coming to Christ. Thousands and thousands being healed. And you and I only see a few that are saved in a crusade or on the platform in healing, where multitudes of millions of people around the world are being touched week after week and day after day by the ministry that God has raised up and by a man that God has anointed with a double portion of his Spirit for these last days and last revival before our Lord comes. Benny, I believe with all of my heart that God calls you, God anointed you, God's going to use you, and you're going to see greater miracles than you've ever seen, more souls saved than has ever been saved in the history of the world. And not only that, I believe such rejoicing is going to take place until one of these days you're going to hear a trumpet sound and the Lord's coming back for a victorious church. Hallelujah. I want a one little PS on this. We ought to pray for this ministry like we have never prayed. We ought to support this ministry. For when we invest our dollars, we invest in souls and sick bodies being healed and the answer to prayer like no other generation has ever had. Let's continue to stand by, let's believe, and let's uphold Benny Hinn until he's reached this world and the glorious Lord shall return. I believe we're living in that day and in that hour. Let's all stand for just one moment. I want every man, every woman, every boy, and every girl to stretch a hand toward Benny Hinn. Now ask God to endue him with a double portion for the last days, the last revival before our Lord comes. Oh, Holy Spirit, thou art so welcome. Thou art so welcome. Touch Benny with a double portion, double anointing. And we pray for God's people to stand with him and lift his hands up. And we pray the whole world shall see the miracle-working power of God and the salvation of the Lord in these last days. Bless him, prosper, use him for your glory in Jesus' name. And everybody said, I love you, Benny.
Now, you know I didn't ask him to say these things. Maud Amy, sweetheart, I want... You know what? Jim, come here a second. Jim Sonora, take this microphone a minute. I'm going to go do something. This precious lady, I've waited so long to get her to a crusade. And every time I'd say come, she couldn't make it. So now... I'm gonna come get you myself.
Okay.
Come on, babe. Come on. No, 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 no. You go first. Come on. It's a precious lady right here. And she's gonna sing tonight. Yes, ma'am. She said, I am. Yeah. You know, dear Maud Amy, you've been serving the Lord with Rex for 60-something years now. You've been married a long time. 59 years they've been married. 59 years. There's a song nobody can sing like Maud Amy. I would love to tell you what I think of Jesus. And since the Lord has been so good to you, would you mind telling us what he's done for you in this beautiful song? Okay.
I would love to tell you what I think of Jesus. Since I found in him a friend so strong and I would tell you how he changed my life completely. He did something that no other friend could do. So kind and need assurance. More and more I understand his words of love. I just love her,
know how it
changed my life completely. Something that no other friend could do. No one ever cared for me like Jesus. There's no darkness from me. Oh, how much he cares for you.
Years ago, I used to sing in the choirs for Catherine Kuhlman. I was sitting in the choir singing, and next to me sat a friend of mine named John Arnott from Toronto. And next to him sat a gentleman named Sandy Fleming. But right next to Sandy was this very elegant Canadian lady from Kitchener, Ontario. This precious woman, very elegant, very eloquent, had arthritis, bad arthritis. In fact, it was so bad, when she'd hold the songbook, and the songbook was like a thin songbook, no more than maybe 10 pages in it. This songbook is probably heavier than the one Paul Farron used to have. And Norval, she was holding that songbook, and tears streaming down her cheeks, not because she felt the presence of God, but because of the pain she was feeling. Just holding the songbook would bring such pain that she'd cry from the pain. Now, many of us in the choir knew that about her, and Sandy Fleming and John and I were friends with this dear lady. We would go to her house for prayer. Now, this precious woman stood there, and you could see the fingers twisted with arthritis. You could see the little bumps on her finger and her hands and her whole body. You could see the arthritis developing in her body. Beautiful blonde, blue eyes, in her 50s, maybe 50, late 50s. She stood there with that hymn, that songbook. The service went on. Catherine's meetings would go on for 5 hours at times. That precious woman sat in that choir, and every time we would sing, the choir had to stand, and every time we stood, the pain would strike her so bad, she'd start crying from the pain. And I began wondering, why is this woman even standing up? Why not just stay seated? Well, because it was so painful for her. At the end of the service, after so many people had been healed, Catherine turned to the choir and said, "Choir, it is well with my soul," because she was giving an altar call, and now the people were coming down getting saved, and the choir began singing, "When peace like a river." And at one point, Miss Kuhlman said, "Not a whisper, just not a whisper." And she was speaking with such a soft voice, you know, you had to struggle to hear what she said. And there was a moment I'll never forget in that service when Miss Kuhlman said, "Not a sound made And that stadium in London, Ontario, Canada. But got so quiet till you could hear a pin drop. And then we heard the lady, the third from Sandy. I heard her say, John heard her, Sandy heard her. The choir members around her heard her say, here's what she said. Jesus, don't forget me, Jesus. Jesus, don't forget me. And the second she said that, the power of God came on her. And she hit the seat. And when she got up, that woman was perfectly healed. It did not take a struggle. It wasn't a long prayer. It wasn't some eloquent prayer. It was a simple prayer that said, don't forget me. Just don't forget me. Saints, you know what he said in his word? He said, you may forget me. But he said, I will never forget you, says the Lord. Never. His name is Jesus. 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 There's just something. Lift your hands and call him Master. Savior. Jesus. Like the fragrance after the rain. Sweet Jesus. Let the earth proclaim. Kings and kingdoms will pass away. This man shaking under the power of God, he and his wife. What happened?
They're ministers. 11 years ago, he broke his back. He has had a morphine pump in his stomach for 8 years. He's been in such pain, could not bend down, is bending down tonight. She is scheduled for a knee replacement surgery, totally free from pain tonight.
People, take your seats, please. You're a minister.
Yes.
What church?
Ebenezer United Methodist.
What was wrong with you?
In 1990, I fell and broke my back. Had a head injury, shoulder injury, surgery on my shoulder, broke elbow, and broke my back. They put steel plates in my back, and then had to put a pump right here that's got Dilaudid in it, puts medicine in my spinal fluid.
What happened here?
I felt the power of God hit me, you know. I tried to say thank you, but I could, all I could do is talk in tongue.
You're shaking now, too. Come here. Come here, come here. Now, is the pain gone?
Pain's gone.
Pardon?
Pain's gone.
Why are you shaking like that?
I don't know. Power, I guess God's all open.
Bend down, touch your toes. All the way. Now, let's swing, my friend. Like that. Look at that. Come on, people. Give the Lord a mighty hand for healing this man. Your husband could not do that.
Come here, lady. Talk to me. Your husband could not do this at all?
No. No, he could.
How long?
10, 11 years.
For 10 or 11 years, he could not do what you just saw him do. Could he run?
No.
Run, my friend. Run.
Look at that.
People, give the Lord a mighty shout of hallelujah. Oh, this is marvelous. Dear Jesus, what can we say, dear Jesus? Dear Jesus, what can we say, Lord? What did you say was wrong with the wife, Suzanne?
She was supposed to have a knee replacement. The pain is totally gone tonight.
Due for surgery, yes.
Here, Henry, you tell me.
So she's due for surgery. And she's the one that had the problem with her knees, but her husband, that's unbelievable, because when he was back there, just seeing the pain leaving his body and now running around.
David, did you see him?
Pastor, she was sitting right over here. I saw them both get touched by the power of God. I talked to her before the service tonight, and she showed me the brace that she was wearing
what
on her
brace?
Knee.
Where is it?
Well, I think it's back in her seat back there. But she said, God's going to heal me tonight, she said.
She had faith.
Yeah.
She believed the Lord. So she left the brace, I guess, back there. Well, let me pick her up so I can talk to her. Leave him on the floor. He needs it. Preachers need a little extra touch every so often. You know what I'm saying? Now, they tell me you had a brace on your leg.
I did. I was scheduled for a complete knee replacement. I was the 15th, but thank God I don't have to have it.
So where is the brace?
I don't know.
It's back there. She doesn't care.
I don't care where.
She was scheduled for surgery. Look at that. The Lord healed the wife and the husband. Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise
the
Lord.
Oh, you got the praise right there. Oh, honey, I don't want. She said, you can have it. You will never be the same again. You got to pick them both up. This is glorious. Bring them here. Bring them, both. Join hands together. We're going to pray God. Don't worry about your pants. They won't fall off, brother. I promise you. Have you ever had this happen to you like that? Huh?
Similar, but not this way.
Where's your church?
It's in North Alabama, next to Crossville, Alabama, Geraldine.
Boy, that church is going to have revival this Sunday. Lord, send a triple portion of the anointing on him and on his church. I pray this Sunday he'll have a healing service, Sunday morning and Sunday night. Lord, increase the membership, increase the numbers, increase the blessings in Jesus' name. Phew. Touch in the name of Jesus, I pray. And the people said,
Pastor, sorry, this is unbelievable. You called out a lady with a brain tumor. She's in the back worshiping the Lord. This is her mom. As you called out the brain tumor, she was worshiping. She felt the hand touch her hand, and instantly...
Wait, she felt a hand?
She felt the hand go against her hand. You got to let her tell you.
Let her.
I was just standing there worshiping the Lord. I saw that hand.
You what now?
I was just standing there worshiping. Because I've prayed for so long for that healing. And I was just worshiping him. I felt his hands go.
You felt the Lord's hand touch your hand like this while you were worshiping him? And you had a brain tumor?
Yes.
Where is it now?
It's gone.
How'd you know?
I can see you.
What do you mean you can see me?
She can see 2-3 of us, she said. Now she can just see one of you. Her eyes cleared up as you said tumor is being healed. Her eyes cleared up.
You're the mother. So because of the tumor, you were seeing more than one person. For how long was she like that?
She has been this way for 8 to 10 years.
Where she would see more than one?
Yes. She's a pharmacist and she had to retire on complete disability.
Because of the tumor?
Because of the tumor. One day she had a major headache and she asked me to rub the back of her head. And when I did, there was the top vertebrae was about this large. And I asked her, what is this? And she said, I don't know. So I said, well, you need to get medical attention. And when she went, the doctor said she could die anytime.
Now, the tumor was still there, you mean today?
Yes, when we came to the service tonight, the tumor. No, it's gone.
It's gone. People, don't you think Jesus deserves a mighty hand of praise for this? I mean, he touched her hand, the tumor is gone, and she can see clearly now. You know, this is amazing. See, the mama is crying like that. Isn't it worth it? This. See how grateful they are? Lift your hands and bless it. Come on, Steve. Jesus, thanks a million. Come on, help me. Jesus, thanks a million. Come on, James. We gotta do it. Jesus, thanks a million. See the mama? Jesus, thanks a million. Jesus, thanks a million for all that you have done.
And may I say something? As you were given this request, I heard the tumor, the statement that you made. And I just stood there and visualized, and as you said, the woman said, Jesus, you know, don't forget me. And I stood there and I prayed for my child. And I felt definitely that God had made a touch. I don't know how the burden just lifted. I felt that something major had happened. This girl has been sick for so long. She has been a potato, a couch potato. And I'm so thankful that God has touched her.
You know, when I look at this, you know, sometimes I need a little... How shall I say, you know, we ministers sometimes need a little touch. This is my reward. See, when I see you healed, when I see your girl healed, that's the touch that touches me. That's what I need. That just gives me a little more courage to go on. We need to see this. You see, I promised him to serve him till the day I die. But every so often, the Lord gives me a little touch and says, Benny, keep going. That's for precious.
This is for real.
I know it's for real.
It's for real. I'm the mother, and I have met many times with her. In fact, the patch has just been taken from her spine. I would take her to the hospital in Columbia, South Carolina. The neurologist would draw all this fluid from her brain, I mean from her spine that was gathering in her body. She has just pulled the patch off. She went one day last week and had the fluid drawn again as high as 4.5 to 5 vials of fluid. She's just pulled this patch off.
Dear Jesus, thanks. Thanks, a million thanks. Oh, that anointing is so strong here, lady. That anointing is just so strong on the people. Just reverently say, praise the Lord. Sue.
You called for arthritis tonight when you did. The power of God went through this lady. She had osteoarthritis since 1997. She's had a tumor on her disc and her back, totally free from pain tonight.
That's wonderful. Look how happy they are when they come up like that. They're so happy. You know, only they know what it's been like all this time. She says, look, you know, I love, pardon?
Look at this.
You Southern people are so sweet. I love Southern people. Isn't that great? That's wonderful. And I love the way you talk too, by the way.
So now, one more time. What was wrong with you?
Okay, I had a thoracic disc tumor, osteoarthritis.
Six crushed vertebrae.
Six crushed vertebrae. And fibromyalgia.
Six crushed vertebrae. Yeah, your wife had more than just a back problem.
Myelogram. I was on a myelogram. Orthopedic surgeon looked at it and a neurosurgeon.
And now the pain is gone.
It's gone.
What did you feel when you were there? Oh, did something come on you? It's just gone?
No, you raised your hand up and I looked up and God reached down. Because remember when you said, God, don't forget me? I said, God, don't forget me either. I'm nobody, but with you, I'm somebody.
Amen. Amen.
What church do you go to?
First Redeemer. First Redeemer Church.
First Redeemer Church.
Tim LaHaye was there a couple of weeks ago, and you came recommended.
He's a dear friend of mine.
He recommended you highly.
Tim LaHaye is Southern Baptist and my dear friend, and he sent them here. Aren't you glad the church is one? The body of Christ is one like that. So wonderful. Dear Jesus, thank you. A million thanks for your anointing. A million thanks for your spirit. Sir.
Pastor, this wonderful couple that's been married for 55 years. She has been suffering with arthritis for 4 years. Power of God came upon her tonight. All of the pain has left her body. She's 83 years young.
Look at her.
She wants to put on some dancing shoes. She hadn't been able to tie shoes, but I watched her over there as she bent down and tied his shoes as they were coming up.
We've always wanted to see you. And we got here.
Your partners, God bless you.
Thank you. I watch every day at 4:30 on Christian television in Florida.
And you are 80, 84?
83.
83.
Yep.
And you had one more time.
Arthritis in my spine, both knees.
And now it's gone?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I love this. Simple faith. All right. Now, show me what you could not do. Like, do something. Pardon?
I couldn't do this.
Couldn't do that.
No. And I couldn't stand in one place for more than 1 minute. I kept sitting down over there, but I stood up over here 3-4 minutes so far.
And no pain now?
No, no pain.
Are you amazed?
No, because it happened to me once before, and I was sitting at home, and I got healed on TV, but somebody talked me out of it, and it came back on me.
Now, wait. Let's talk about this. Come here a minute. Come here. Pardon?
The devil gets in your way sometimes, and he comes back and gets you back thinking you got pains. And the first thing you know, you got arthritis again.
Lady, preach it.
Yeah, preach it. Tell him.
You've got to be what?
Once you get your healing, you can't let go of it. You've got to be in the Word all the time.
That's right.
Yeah.
So somebody got in your way, you said?
Yes, they kept convincing me. They said, well, you really aren't healed. You've got pain, haven't you? After a while, I began to think I did have. First thing you know, I had arthritis.
You see? Now listen, this is very important. We receive it by faith. We must keep it by faith. That's it. And when somebody comes and puts some doubt in there,
right.
They come and put questions. Even Christians say, yeah, maybe it was all in my mind and you believe it.
Yes, they said, after all, you are 83, you should have arthritis.
Is that what they said?
Yeah. And I said, no way.
Did you hear that? They said, well, you're 83, you should have arthritis. Now, next time that happens, don't say that to the people, but look at the devil and say, now, devil, you're a liar. Get out. That's it. Because the devil uses people to bring doubt back. Remember when even Peter the apostle came to Jesus and said, no, don't go to the cross. Jesus said, get behind me, devil. Right? So it's the Word.
It's the Word, yeah.
Yeah. Now, how long have you been saved?
Well, since I was about 12, 14 years old.
And even there, somebody could convince you it wasn't real, you see?
No, we were very active in the church. My husband and I had a youth group. He was superintendent of Sunday schools, and I taught Sunday school. We've been in church for a long time, years
now,
and years.
Don't lose it now.
No.
Never.
No, never.
Dear Jesus, thank you. May she live to be 100 for your name's sake. Amen and amen. And touch the dear husband, dear Jesus, touch the dear husband. Now, pick her up because I saw she had some hearing aids. Let's ask the Lord to fix her all up. Come on, people, let's believe. All right. Yeah, take him out. Let's all pray. Come on. Stretch your hands. Dear Jesus. Oh, there it is. I command the deafness to go. That spirit of deafness in this precious 83-year-old lady will go and not come back. In Jesus' name. Touch! Whoa! Can you hear me?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Shut my mic.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes.
Come on, people. Give a big God bless you. God bless you. Now pick up her husband. Pick up her husband. Pardon?
He's only 77.
Oh, he's younger than you.
Oh, well, I picked him young, raised him my way.
I want you to see what used to be. Now, I want you to see what has happened tonight. Suffering with lupus. Somebody had to...
Come on, people, give the Lord a mighty hand.
Pastor, somebody had to dress her tonight. She could not even come. Somebody had to dress her. She hadn't dressed her baby in months. All the pain is gone out of her body. She just got out of the hospital with a blood infection caused by lupus. But you said, you pointed straight out and you said, someone in the center is suffering with lupus. In fact, the pain is still in your body. But get up and walk out. That's exactly what she did. And she went from that to that.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Yeah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah is right, lady.
Pastor Benny, Jesus is my healer. I knew that. I came here because my mother's been on dialysis for 12 years and I wanted to stand in the gap for her. And I just got ill. So I was expecting my healing, but I was more focused on my family and my child, my three-year-old. And Lord help me, Jesus, when you look back there, you said somebody straight back in front of me is being healed of a blood disease. And I just reached up and received it. And then you said to step out, and I felt the pain leaving, but it was from my neck all the way to the bottom of my feet. And I didn't want to wait for it to leave, because I figured if I stepped out and believed God and His Word, He would heal me. I was healed before I got here. But arthritis pain is gone. I couldn't even close these hands. Everything is gone. Praise Jesus.
And you just stepped out.
I just stepped out in faith. Stepped out on His Word. If God said it, He's gonna do it. He'll do it. He'll do it. Just take Him at His Word. He's not a man that He should lie, Pastor Ben. He's not a man that He should lie. He's not a man that He should lie. His Word is true. He said His Word and healed Lisa Anderson. He said His Word and He healed you. Whoa.
See, simple faith. That's all. Pick up that key and sing it again. Stand up, choir, please. Jesus, thanks. Pick it up. Pick it up. Never again, Lord. Never again. Touch. Never again. In the name of Jesus. Somebody say amen. You are worthy to be praised. Lift your hands and tell Him, saints. Lord, I love You and I worship You. You are worthy.
The power of God on these people. Yes, Pastor. God is suffering with cancer in his stomach, walked with bent over because of the pain. All of the pain is gone out of this young man. He says tonight he is healed.
The pain
is gone.
Because of cancer in his stomach, he walked like this.
Pardon?
We came from London just for this.
England?
Yes. Yesterday.
You came from England for this?
Yes.
You flew here from England?
Yesterday. Yes.
Yesterday?
Yes.
Expecting a miracle?
Expecting a miracle, yes. Yes.
And the pain is gone?
The pain is gone. Diagnosed 1997. Heart surgery, chemo, recalled this year, early last year, and I've had this prayer to my kidney, my lungs, my liver, all the left hand side. My
now it's gone totally.
I can't feel any pain.
Squeeze it.
Just, you know, and I had a serious growth behind my back, pressing on all my sacral nerves. So much discomfort.
Here, hold this. Now you tell me if there's any pain, then, all right?
I don't.
No pain?
No pain.
Hey guys, come here. You squeeze him. Come on. Any pain?
No pain.
Just ticklish. I didn't ask you to tickle him. I asked you to squeeze him. Dear Jesus, thank you. Somebody say praise the Lord.
Who is this lady here? From where? She's a minister. Come here, my dear. So that's the preacher.
Been an incredible prophetic anointing.
I've never seen her. I promise you, I've never seen this woman. The Lord just said to me, he said, this is a vessel of the kingdom. Use her, I pray, mightily. Mightily. Let your name be honored greatly through this vessel. Let your glory be manifested greatly through her life. May she be counted worthy of your divine glory. So few are privileged to know it. So few have known it, for the price is great. Let her pay the price for greater revelations and manifestations of your presence. Let the fire of God be hers. Take of that which is on my life and place it on her, I pray. Release it mightily. Fire in the name of the Lord, my God. There is glory on this lady. Sue, you've heard her preach. Talk to me.
5 minutes ago, I said to Henry, I said, the anointing is all over Juanita. She's supposed to be on this platform because the Lord said one of the reasons she's here tonight is because she's been known for the prophetic, but he's going to move her into a healing anointing.
Bring her up here. Awesome. Awesome. Listen, the prophetic is on her now. But just before anything happens, remain standing, please. If you want Jesus Christ to change your life, if you want the greatest miracle that can happen to any man, if you want the most amazing thing to happen to you, when Jesus becomes yours, real, more real than life itself, as great as these miracles are, as great as they are, yes, Lord, I'll do it. That's right, Master. Thus saith the Lord, woman of God, greater revelations, greater manifestations, greater glories, much greater than you can believe for is before you. Like a table spread
with the best of heaven is yours. A table has been spread before you, O vessel of the kingdom. And this table belongs to my people. But you will be taught by my Spirit to show them the way to my banquet house. You will be taught the way. You will be shown how to feed my inheritance and how to show them, how to teach them. Yes, says the Lord, as you speak, they will learn how to receive of the best of heaven. The table is spread. The glory and the honor and the majesty of my name is on that banquet table. And I will show you and I will reveal to you depth in the Spirit, that you might help my inheritance receive it. You might help my inheritance eat of it. For without it, my people are famished. Without my glory, without my revelation, without my authority spread for them, they will not know victory or liberty against the enemies of their souls. But today, if you will come into what I am, if you will seek me as never before, if you'll call my name from the depth of your heart and being, I will answer you and I will reveal to you what I reveal to my servants, the prophets. Only what I have revealed in my word will I reveal to you and no more. But yes, says the Lord, for greater revelations have come to the prophets of old than many who live today. Many have not seen the revelations that Moses knew and Elijah knew and John knew. Yes, but today I am bringing you and I am bringing servants like you into the depth of my glory, where they'll know my eyes are fire, my voice as many waters, and my glory that will fill their hearts. Yes, as the Lord, be ready. Be ready. Now, dear Jesus, this cannot be planned by men. But now I pray as she stands on this platform, and as I give the altar call that your people might come to know you, that these who are bound might be free, let this woman receive of heaven on this platform. Master, I pray in the next 5 minutes, may you sow in her what no education can give, what no book can reveal, in Jesus' name. Fire on your life! Leave her there for 5 minutes. Now people, only God can plan this. Now, you see, the Lord just stopped me like this and he said, give her the word quickly. Because the Lord wanted her to lay before him for 5 minutes. Had I not done this now, this woman would not have received what she's receiving right this second. Surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. If you want Jesus, if you want the Master to change your life, there's such a holy anointing here. If you want him to transform you completely, right now, come stand right here. From all over the stadium, come stand right here. If you want Jesus Christ to change your life, if you want to surrender, come right now. Dear Jesus, I believe you are the Son of God. I believe you came to earth and died for me on a cross. And I believe you shed your blood for my soul. And I believe you rose from the dead and you're alive forevermore.
And you are seated at God's right hand, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. Right now, I give you my heart, my life. I surrender to you, dear Jesus. Cleanse me with your blood. Purify me completely. Come into my heart. Sweet Jesus, I accept you as my Lord, my Savior, my King, my Redeemer. And I proclaim I belong to Jesus forever. I do not belong to Satan. I've been purchased by the blood. I belong to Jesus, and I am His forever. And I am born again. Amen. 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 Give the Lord a mighty, mighty hand of praise, saints. Father God, let them know they're your children. Let them know they've passed from death to life and from darkness to light. Fill them with thy spirit, I pray, that they might walk with you in holiness and obedience. That thy people might know you in depth is my prayer. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Lift up this vessel of the Lord. There is a depth that belongs to everybody here. And I don't know what word God has put in you, but there's a word in you. You mind sharing it?
Be still and know that I am God. You must be still and this would be like no other. For I hear the Spirit of the Lord saying, all that you have heard about my servant Benny, the glory that shall be upon him in this meeting, nothing is to be compared. For I have chosen even this place to increase the anointing on his life beyond the walls. For they shall pull up on the parking lot, and before they get out of the car, the healing power will begin. For after this night, no longer will that anointing be confined to an auditorium or a building. it shall move in the city. It shall move in the streets. It shall move on the parking lot. For this night, saith the Spirit of the Lord, I increase the anointing on his life. For this night, said the Spirit of the Lord, the things that he has suffered behind closed doors that you know nothing of, the warfare that he has gone through in his mind that you know nothing of, but I have chosen this meeting and I shall pay him for his suffering, and the anointing shall be greater than it's ever been. So I say unto you, my people, don't pull on what you see. Don't pull on what's familiar to you. But pull on the supernatural. For standing in this building tonight, for the Spirit of the Lord saying, I have ordained this night before the foundation of the world. And yes, many have come into the auditorium for physical healing. But I hear the Spirit of the Lord said, I've chosen this meeting. And many that stand in here tonight, and your spirit have been dry, and your anointing have been dry. As the man of God lifts his hand, I will charge your anointing again. I will charge your spirit again. For this time, it is not just for the physical, but it is for the spiritual. It is for the supernatural. Receive it now. In the next 30 seconds, in the next 30 seconds, there's about to be a wave that's about to hit this place. And every person that is a believer, he said, not only are you going out of here physically healed, but I'm getting ready to turn up the volume in your spirit. And your loved ones shall be saved. And you shall cast out devils. You shall lay hands on the sick. In the next 10 seconds, as I call Suzanne to me, for I hear the Spirit of the Lord saying, no more in the background. For I hear the Spirit of the Lord saying, for as you have shed it pounds, so have you shed it the old person. For this one that stands in here tonight is a brand new creature in Christ, and I shall use you, and you shall look in the television, and you shall prophesy, and you shall speak the word of the Lord, said the Spirit of the living God. For even as you lay on the floor, I've given you an anointing even now to touch the mind of manic depressants, to touch the mind of women that think that they're just housewives, to touch the minds of women that think that God has just called them to stand in the shadow of the men of God. But oh, great woman of God, as you lay on the floor tonight, your spirit is being flipped over, for a new level of intercession shall come upon you, and you shall be bold in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And I say unto the fellow men, and I say unto the servants of God, and I get on my knees tonight as I give the men of God this word. I get on my knees to humble myself in the presence of the men of God. He said, not in this meeting. Let it not be said that you sit on the platform and just cross your legs and be honored to be on Benny's platform. He said, but this time, I want you to catch the power. This time, I want you to catch a new anointing. This time, I'm going to put a glory upon your ministries, and your churches will not be the same. And and your prayer life will not be the same, and your preacher will not be the same, said the Spirit of the living God. And as I stand with my hands lifted up in total surrenderance to God, he said, in this house, in the next 60 seconds, as you begin to open up your mouths and begin to wail out in his presence, he said, I shall restore unto you everything that the devil is trying to steal from you. He said, begin to shout. Begin to give him glory. Begin to give him praise. Come on, turn it up. Turn everything up. Let everything that had breath praise the Lord. On the cymbals, on the high-sounding cymbals, on the instruments, on the organ, let everything that had breath praise the Lord. He's worthy. A few more seconds. A few more seconds. A few more seconds. And the glory of the Lord is here.
Worship him with me tonight. Because in my life, he's my master. Redeemer, Savior of the world, he's so wonderful. My counselor, the bright morning star. So many times he's been the lily of my valley, our provider, my very best friend. He was yesterday, he'll be there tomorrow, the beginning and the end. Oh, but the angel called him Jesus, born of ago, Gabriel called him Yeshua. He was born of a virgin. How many of you really believe that? His mother obeyed and called him Yeshua, just so that we can call him Lord. But can I tell you, we're not alone tonight, because with us,
all of heaven calls him King Jesus, and heaven's King was born of a virgin. He's the Son of God, and all heaven's angels, they bow and call him Jesus. Oh, but still I call him Lord. Would you worship him tonight? I know Mary, his mother, called him
This is Martin Luther King's daughter. That's right. This is Bernice King. This is a preacher, by the way. This lady is a preacher. And when I said to her last night, when I asked her a little bit about her faith, to find out she's a charismatic Baptist-costal, as she said. So will you join hands together? Her daddy with, please join hands everywhere. Her daddy was used by God to change not only American history but the world. Because of his life, America again understands what liberty is. Sadly, in some circles, racism is still alive. People have not realized that God Almighty does not see color. God is black, God is white, he's yellow and brown. He's light. Light has all colors in it. I want to remind you that the Pentecostal movement in Los Angeles, California started with an Afro-American minister. We have what we have because of that precious man of God. The Azusa Street revival began in a house. My wife and I years ago went to that house, and I knocked on the door, and that opened the precious, the door was opened by a precious angelic lady, her face beaming with light. She did not know who I was. This was many years ago, way before I was even on television. We just gotten married and went to Los Angeles to preach for Ralph Wilkerson. And a gentleman from his church took us down to Azusa. I said, I want to see where it all started. And we walked into that house. Precious lady said to me, oh, come in, come in. They come from all over the world, she said. I said, I just want to see where it all began. And we're standing there and she said, this is the piano. I was standing right by it. And then she said, and this is the spot where the man of God was standing. And I didn't want to move, I froze. That moment left a mark on my life. Let's not forget what God has done, saints. Now I'm going to ask you to do something, Bernice, and I'm led by the Lord to do this. I want you to pray for America. Pray for the church, especially in America, that God would unite his people in America.
Hallelujah. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, we are gathered together in your name. And we're in the midst of your presence. Father God, we come humbly before you and just, first of all, Father God, we want to repent for every sin that we have committed in the name of Jesus. Lord God, as your children, we want to come even now standing in the gap for our nation and even our world, Lord God. You said in your word, if my people who are called by my name, Father God, and we are those that are called by your name, would just humble themselves. Father God, even now, we are humbled before you, God. Some of us in our hearts, Lord God. Some of us even now, Lord God, have kneeled on our knees, God, because we are humbly submitting to your presence, Father God. You said if we would humble ourselves and we would pray, Father God, in the name of Jesus, and if we would seek your face, Father God, and turn from our wicked ways, Jesus, hallelujah, Lord God, even now, Father God, even now, we repent, Lord God, of every sin that America has committed in the name of Jesus, Father God. We repent in the name of Jesus for every slave trade that occurred in this nation in the name of Jesus, for every, Lord God, hatred, act of hatred that has occurred, Lord God, in the name of Jesus in this nation, Lord God, we repent for it in the name of Jesus, for every exploitation and injustice, Father God, we repent for it right now in the name of Jesus, Lord God. We repent, God, for the spirit of arrogance and elitism, Lord God. Hallelujah. Not just historically, Lord God, but even right now and right here in the name of Jesus, we rebuke that spirit. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We bind it in the name of Jesus. Every spirit of selfishness, every spirit of greed and materialism, Lord God, in America that is destroying our homes, Lord God, that's destroying our families, we repent of them, Lord God, and we rebuke those very spirits out of our lives in the name of Jesus. God, we thank you for the grace and we thank you for the mercy that you've had on this nation, Father God, Lord God, but we pray right now, God, through the power of your Holy Spirit, that you would begin to convict souls through the power of the Holy Ghost, that there's only one way, and that way is through Jesus. He is the truth, he is the way, and he is the life. Father God, I come before you burdened. I praise you for this man of God in obedience, God. It's been in my belly concerning the divisiveness that's in the body, Father God. You showed me that the body of your Son and our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, shed blood, Lord God. But not one bone was broken in that body. But yet, Father God, we are broken. We are separated and we are divided, God. And we pretend as if we are united in the spirit, God. We're sorry, Lord God, for presenting this kind of front to you in the name of Jesus, God. Make us right in our hearts. Even right now, God, begin to purge us of this sin, God. Because the world can't see Jesus until they see true love between your children cross-culturally. Heal us, God. Everything that has hurt us, heal us. Give us a spirit of forgiveness, Lord God. Give us a spirit of truth, Lord God. Even now, in the name of Jesus, I pray, God, that you cause a spiritual revolution in this area. That we not just come together physically, Lord God, in a building and worship you, God. That, God, we really connect heart to heart and soul to soul, Lord God. That we really feel each other, God, and know each other. And as we connect truly, God, not superficially, but truly, then, God, we believe that the revival we've been praying for in America, it will come. But it must begin first in the body. We thank you, God, and we praise you, God, for what you're even doing right now in our midst. And we honor you for being King of Kings and Lord of Lords. In Jesus' name, let every heart say amen. Amen. And hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Come on, give the Lord a mighty hand of praise. Thanks. Shady green pastures, so rich and so sweet, God leads his dear children alone. Where the waters cool flow, waves the weary one's feet, God leads his dear children alone. Some through the water, some through the flood, some through the fire, but all through the blood. Some through great sorrow, sometimes on the mount where the sun shines so bright, God leads his dear children alone. I've been there. Sometimes in the valley, in the darkest of night, God leads his dear children alone. Away from the mire, away from the clay, God leads his dear children alone. Away up in glory, eternal.
Through the fire, through the fire, through That one time they tried to fix it by surgery to try and remove the scar tissue off the nerve. And they said if that didn't work, there was nothing more doctors could do for it. And for the first time, it doesn't hurt.
Both of you.
Yeah, we watch you. We watch you every night. We was praying that you would come to Atlanta where we could be here. And God showed us a way to be here. And he healed me.
Both of you came out of wheelchair.
And both of us came out of wheelchair.
Come on, people. Come on.
Not been able to do that.
Oh, thank you, Lord Jesus.
We're so grateful. We are so grateful. So very grateful. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Lift your hands and bless him. Worthy of praise, worthy of glory, worthy of honor and thanksgiving. You know, I usually like to sing it, Jesus all glorious. I've had such a long day today. And the Holy Spirit said, it's all right, baby, it's just all right. Just worship him. And I began to lead an hallelujah. Only God knows what I feel right now. I'm so grateful. I'm so grateful you called me. I'm so very grateful. You've given me that privilege to see your precious people healed. I'm glad you called me. I'll wear out for you. I'll gladly wear out for you. Just to see this. I don't know what's happening to me. I don't do these things. I meant it when I said, you've waited so long, you said.
I've waited so long for this to happen. This has been on me for 6 years. And I've been God's child ever since 95. And I've been praying to God to heal me. And he was just waiting for you to come down here.
6 years were you in the wheelchairs, is that right?
In and out. As far as I could walk, as I from the bedroom to the bathroom.
Who is this young man?
This is my grandson, Donnie Stevens.
You've not seen your grandmama do that?
Not in a long time.
You know what it's like to serve the Lord, young man?
Yes, sir.
I pray one day you'll know it real good. You know, I know, you know, I've seen miracles before, guys. I know that. I'm just so overwhelmed. I tell you, I am just so grateful to you. So grateful to you, Lord. So grateful. Oh. I tell you, I just don't know what to say. Jim, I sat yesterday with my Bible. And I said, Lord, don't let any part of me belong to anybody else. Let nothing in me belong to the world. Let nothing in me belong to the world. I want every cell in my body. I want every part of me yours.
you people, you just don't know what the devil has tried to do. You just don't know the pain. You don't know the agony. You don't know. You don't know. You don't know the trials I've gone through the last 2 years of my life. But I tell you something. When the devil comes at you like this, there's only one place to go to. Into the arms of the Master. That's it. I'm so grateful for men like this, gentlemen. I'm so grateful. I love him like my flesh and blood. So grateful. So grateful he stands there behind me and worships with me and leads the great choir. So grateful. I can ask for people like that. They just come. God sends them. So grateful for dear sweet Cheryl Palmquist. Plays that beautiful organ. Loves him with all her heart. Tears flowing down her cheeks as she plays. David, Bruce, Steve, I love you with all my heart. So glad you're true to his work. So glad you're true to his work. And you know, sometimes I think it just overwhelms me, that's all. Sometimes I just stay there and I say, Lord, I'm just overwhelmed. That's all I can say. You know, we see miracles. We see more miracles than anybody alive, I think. It's not the miracles. It's the fact he's using us. The fact he's given us this privilege. You know what the apostles must have felt like when they said to him, they said, if you mention his name, we'll put you in jail. We'll kill you. You gotta stop that. And they whipped them. They couldn't kill him. God would have not let that happen. But they said, thank you. They looked up and said, thank you for the honor that we've been whipped for you. I was at a gas station a few months ago on my way to Palm Springs. My little boy was in the car and Henry was, help him up, will you guys? Remain standing. This is so holy here. Please remain standing. Oh, don't go down. Don't go down. Get back here. I'm going nowhere, she says. My brother Henry had gone in to pay for the gas, and I was outside by the car. My little boy in the back seat, and Henry's son, my nephew, a young man, comes up to me with a big heavy Bible in his hand. He says, Benny Hinn, you're a false prophet. My little boy in the back said, get out of here, leave my daddy alone. My Joshua was 10 years old. He says, I think you're a false prophet, Benny Hinn. I said, young man, that's your opinion. And I turned away and I said, thank you for the privilege that for you today I was called a false prophet. I said, thank you. Thank you for reminding me of the price. Thank you. Thank you that you said when they say all manner of evil things against you, rejoice. I didn't even care the guy was there. I just closed my eyes and said, thank you, Lord. You say, how can you thank him? Oh, people, you don't understand. The Christian life doesn't come with chocolate only. It comes with bitterness at times. We thank him for everything. Now, as you remain standing, Mar Amy, come here, sweetheart. See, the power of God is still flowing. Lift your hands and receive now. Come on. Don't worry about what I'm doing up here. Come here, Rex. Come here, Rex. How I've loved this man. How I've loved this man. You know what he said to me a few days ago? He said, Benny, Oral and I were talking, Benny. And Oral and I don't think we'll be here too long.
That's right.
You know what you said to me?
Yep. And I said, you've got a great responsibility, a great call from Almighty God like no one I've ever seen.
You know, Rex, I'm so grateful the Lord sent you my way, and Oral, I can talk to you. I see Oral every single week. I sit with him. And you know, I've said to these men, I said, please don't leave yet. I need you around. And he said to me one day, he said, Oral and I don't think we'll be here for too much longer. We're depending on you, Benny, to stay strong.
Amen.
We're depending on you to be faithful. My Amy, sweetheart, I don't know why this is happening tonight. Only God knows. Would you please sing it for me? He touched me. Please. As we stand here watching these miracles come up. Come on.
Shackled by a heavy burden.
The blessed Savior.
Since I met the blessed Savior,
since it's cleansed and made me whole,
since He cleansed and made me whole,
I'll never cease to praise.
I will never cease to praise Him.
I'll shout it while eternity rolls. Sing it with us.
Something happened.
Pastor, this dear lady has for 16 years suffered greatly in her body. She has had 11 back operations.
Dear Lord.
She has 4 pins in her legs. She has had to be in this motorized scooter here.
Bring it up here.
In order to get around.
That's a heavy thing, isn't it?
In and out of a wheelchair.
350 pounds.
You could leave it down there. And?
Tonight, in 1998, while watching you on her hospital bed, she rededicated her life to Jesus Christ. Came to the crusade in 99 in Memphis. The Lord did not heal her there, but said he would in his time. Tonight was his time, because all of the pain has gone out of her body. She says she is completely healed.
Totally.
I don't hurt. Nowhere.
You just don't hurt.
I just don't hurt. I haven't hurt. I don't know how to not hurt. It's been so long.
How many years?
16.
16? 1 6?
1 6.
16 years with pain.
31 years old. Now you know how old I am.
And look at you. Nothing.
Nothing. I'm fine.
Let me see. Pardon?
What would you like for me to do?
Anything you could not do. Bend down.
That's 11.
That's so wonderful. You know, the world may say this is in our minds. They may say this is all an act. I feel so sorry for the people who say that. But look at you, totally healed.
I'm fine.
After 16 years, Jesus, thank you. Thank you. I feel your presence so glorious. I can't describe this to you. I can't. I just feel him so close to me. So close to me. That's right. Lord, we praise you. Lord, we people, if I can only describe this, I can't. I'm having a hard time ministering. I feel him so close to me. So very close. Pick her up, please. Please, dear Jesus, just a moment, please. Thank you. Just lift your hands and love him. Yeah.
Amazing story, Pastor. She's had major problems in her back. She has 4 titanium pins in her right leg. Pastor, the thing that broke me the most about this lady, she says, I have woke up every morning crying because of the pain, but all of the pain is gone. She'll wake up in the morning and not cry. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Every morning.
In the morning, she won't shed a tear.
Every night on TV. I watch you every night that you're on TV again, and I cry when you pray, hoping the Lord will hear my prayers and answer my miracle.
What was wrong with you again? Please forgive me. I just wasn't listening.
I fractured my right leg. I fell off of a wall. I've got 4 titanium pins in it. Last year, I fell in the garage, and I fractured 4 ribs. My sciatic nerve and crushed a vertebrae, and since then it has affected my breathing, and I feel like I'm getting emphysema, which my mother had. But it's all better, and I couldn't bend over even to pick up anything, and I've been in here tonight bending over.
Let me see. The healer from Galilee is here. Lady, you don't have to go back to your seat even worrying about anything more anymore. Do you feel what I'm feeling?
I feel fullness in my soul. All around my heart, this like the Lord has touched me in here, and he says it's gonna be okay.
That's right. That's all right. So right. John, pick her up. Holy, holy. That's glorious on you. Jesus is so close. Please, Master. Please, Lord. Talk to me.
Pastor, this young man was called into the ministry. This young man was in a seminary, filled with the Holy Spirit, fell into sin, committed a homosexual act, became a homosexual, got hooked on drugs. For the last 3 years...
Look at the power,
yes,
of God
coming
on here.
For the last 3 years... For the last 3 years, he has been struggling with drugs. He believes God has delivered him tonight. He said if the Lord didn't deliver him, he was going to take his life because he's tried it again, tried it before. But I must say, God,
Stephen. I've never felt the Lord so close to me on the platform. There's not a sickness, there's not a bondage, there's not a problem he won't correct. Young man, Jesus Christ makes you whole, young man. Jesus Christ makes you whole. Touch! People, Jesus is here. Lift your hands and love him. I want to know what she is feeling. pick her up.
What's happening to you?
When you said touch to the young man, I felt it go through my body. And it's just breathe better.
You can breathe now.
Yes.
Breathe in. Demon of homosexuality will not have this young man. Free! Give the Lord a mighty shout! The devil is coming out of him this very moment, people of God. Look at this. The demon is coming out of him this very moment. Whom the Son sets free is free. Come out of him in the name of the Lord, my God, my King and Savior. Come out of him. 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 I said out of him. Go. The man is free. What's happening to you, my friend? Huh?
God is on me.
God is on you, all right.
God has called me to go and preach his gospel to people in bondage that do not think that they have any hope, right here.
Be free, my friend, in Jesus' name. Somebody shout hallelujah! My God. Softly, he is here.
Hypothyroidism.
Take your seats, people.
Hypothyroidism, which has affected her growth. She and this other boy are twins. She's been in pain. The pain is totally gone, and the power of God's been all over
her
tonight.
Baby, come here. Come here. Put your mic down. Come here, sweetie. Honey, thank you for being so sweet to me. Pay the price. Paying the price. I've never felt the Lord so close on a platform. I'm telling you, if I don't hold on to somebody or something, I'll be on the floor. But I got work to do here. Love you. Keep working. What was wrong with you now? With your family? Tell me again, please.
Hello, Benny. First,
hello, sweetheart. How are you?
I'm wonderful. Thank you. This precious child has suffered for years and years and years, Benny, with hypothyroidism, which has affected so much. her growth. She's a few years delayed. Brain, food allergies, can't absorb food. And we've just prayed and prayed and prayed for years. And in a recent crusade, there was a girl who was short. And you healed her.
That Jesus.
Jesus healed her. Forgive me, Father, I know that. And I said, Father, if thou wilt, you're not a respecter of persons. You're the same yesterday, today, and forever. You did it for her. Father, do it for Brittany and Benny. This morning never happened to me before. The glory of God came on me. The Spirit, I fell back several times. I couldn't lift by myself in the prayer closet. Couldn't lift my head or hands. The glory of God, I couldn't do anything 4 or 5 times. And he said to me, today is her day. She's made whole. Hallelujah.
Come here, baby. Look at the smile, people. Look at the smile. The smile tells the story. Look at the smile. The Lord healed you?
Yes, sir.
How'd you know?
Because I don't feel a tummy ache anymore.
No more. No more. Thanks. Touch the children. Touch the mommy, I pray. Touch the daddy, I pray. Watch the baby. Touch the young man. And don't forget the little kiddo. And the people said, that is just so beautiful.
Pastor, this is Dr. Maroun Bereket. Mm-hmm. He's from Lebanon.
Yes.
He is director of the VA hospital in Texarkana. He is a doctor. Mm. He has been suffering greatly with cancer. Mm. It spread from his rectum in through into his bones and all through his body. But the power of God touched him tonight. He has no pain whatsoever.
My.
The doctors gave him 1 year to live. He's coming close to that 1 year now. They cannot believe what's going on in his life. And he says tonight was the final episode. God has completely healed the doctor.
You are a medical doctor.
Naam, yes.
From Lebanon.
Naam, yes.
Naam means yes in Arabic. And God healed you?
I believe so, Pastor.
How'd you know?
I had pain in the bone right here, in my hip line, and on the femur joint. I couldn't do these maneuvers without any pain. I couldn't do this without any pain. Now I don't have any pain whatsoever.
A doctor.
Yes.
Dear Jesus, are you his friend? You're his brother. Oh, my friend, nobody comes up here and gets nothing. Susu, talk to me, honey.
Degenerative joint disease, came out of a wheelchair tonight, and also kidney problems, and believes the Lord has touched her.
Which wheelchair? That one right there.
The one on the end.
This one right here.
Yes, sir.
What was wrong with you?
I had degenerated knees for 5 years. All the cartilage gone out of my knees. I've taken medicine every day for the pain in my knees. And I believe if I could come here, God would heal me.
And he did.
And he did. And I believe that he have healed my kidneys. I believe that he have healed my kidneys.
Oh, Jesus, we believe with her. Oh, bless the Lord. Your presence is so great. From the top of her head to the soles of her feet. Oh, there's power on this lady. Who are you?
That's my grandmother. That's my husband's grandmother.
Young lady, what do you want from the Lord?
Peace of mind and closer walk with him.
That's the greatest request anybody can make. The greatest request. Pick up the grandmama. You see how much he loves his people.
Yes. Yes, Maha, shut up.
Shut up. When they want to praise the Lord, I will not interrupt.
So. Suffering with emphysema, Pastor, also a heart condition. Lady's been suffering greatly in her body. She's had to have treatments, breathing treatments, every 3 to 5 hours. Came in a wheelchair. Power of God came upon her actually last night. She has been without oxygen for 27 hours. Lord. She says, the Lord
is healing. I see you every day at 2:30. I sit there and thank God I get to see you in person. Hallelujah. And so many times I've laid my hands on that screen.
Sweetheart, I'm so glad the Lord touched you.
Yes.
And now the Lord has taken away the sickness?
Yes, He has. I have my healing.
That's right. That's right. That's beautiful. That's right. She said, I got it now.
Yes.
I got it now. I don't know what's happening here. I feel like I'm walking on a cloud. I feel lighter than a feather. Pick up the one who's trembling like that. Bring her here. Look at that. You don't understand the glory here. Are you all right?
Yes.
Take it again. Look at that anointing. Look, see, they don't know what's going on. That's the glory of God. Young man, don't try. Just don't try. Oh, he's getting it. Breathe here. He's getting that overflow. That anointing is so strong here. Kent, are you all right? He's his brother. It's glorious, isn't it? A little more of it there. Ooh. I love it, don't you?
She had 3 fractured discs in her back. She's been in so much pain. She's been in the bed for 23 hours a day. Today.
What? 23 hours a day in bed? Pick up that lady here. Bring her here. Isn't this glorious?
Yes.
She's just been healed too.
Praise God.
Go give her a hug.
Give me a good God.
Oh, lady, what? Oh, glory. And then the Asanarakasi. I had open heart surgery. Oh, I had 7 discs in my back. I fell and broke it again. This is my daughter, Liberty. Because, you know, sometimes I can't talk. But, you know, the Lord talks all the time for me. You know what? A lot of people don't believe God talks back to you. But, Benny, I know you know. And I know you, every one of your workers, I know you like, because I go to sleep by you every night. Yes, I do.
Wait,
God told me if I just made it to you, honey, I would make it. And He told me I was going to get healed 3 weeks ago. What? And I they couldn't get here last night. I couldn't get here. But I got here tonight. You know what? God made the way. He told me to be quiet. Tell her, she'll tell you.
Are you talking English or tongues?
I told myself, I'm talking to you, and I know God knows what I'm saying. You know, do you? Brock, I'd like to love it.
Hey, come here, Brock. Come here. Come here, Brock. Come quick.
Please, Steve.
Tell him.
Steve, I want to just hug you. I just want to hug you. I'm 81, and I love you. I watch you so much, and I pray so much. And I'm an interceder with you.
Oh, thank you, sweetie.
And
There is such glory.
I'm going to tell you. My Lord, the power. Oh, hala, ma sakuta la ma yera bohos haya. Kaprote yadres mete yabora sataya.
Are you all right, lady? Are you all right?
I don't know.
See?
Oh. Danny's taking
it. Take all of it. Take all of it. Somebody shout hallelujah. Pastor, this is unbelievable. These two ladies met each other in the hall upstairs, way up there. They're both crying. This one was hemorrhaging for 30 days, bleeding for 30 days. Tonight, she put her hand there, all the blood ceased, all dried up, and this one here had two lumps in her throat, parathyroid in her throat, and she was really...
She was what?
Whoa! The power of God hit him. Did you see that? Pick him up. What is it, Henry? That's the glory of God here.
I don't know.
You people, the presence of God is so strong here. Just lift your hands. I never seen my brother do that. Never seen that. Let's all stand in the presence of the Master. Bring him here, bring him here. Pick him up, bring him here. What do you feel on you, lady? What do you feel on you?
I feel the presence of God on me. I had a hyperparathyroidism.
That's right.
Thank you, Lord.
You see, I understand. You guys tell me about the healing, but you don't realize who's around me. And then you feel him like that. You feel him. You too, aren't you?
Lord.
You must live a holy life. Remember, this is too holy. You understand that? We're just so grateful. Lift your hands and say, I'm so grateful. You know, one time in Catherine's meeting, I felt what she just felt in a somewhat of a way, and I was sitting down and felt this numbness come by me and frighten me. This is not me, Henry. You know that, don't you? Bless these young men, oh Master. Bless them. As a great day ahead for you, it's a great day ahead for the church, great day. Greater than you've believed for, imagined, greater. You know, the presence of the Lord I've been feeling here tonight is too wonderful to describe, too wonderful to talk about. To be frank with you, this body can't handle too much of this. One day, thank God, He'll give us a brand new one that will be able to handle a lot more than this one can. There's glory. Just His glory. Just His glory. Lift your hands and thank Him. It's just right, the right song. You can't go wrong. You are beautiful beyond description. Tell him, choir, tell him.
Of your